In this quick video, I just want to show you how you can download the Windows 11 ISO file for ARM or ARM based PCs, because Microsoft recently made this directly downloadable from the Windows 11 downloads page. So an ARM based processor or ARM based processor is just a different type of architecture. So the most common types we've been using up until now is x64 or x86. And if you go to the normal download Windows 11 page, you'll see that you can download the Windows 11 ISO file for x64 devices or 64-bit devices. So Windows 11 doesn't have a 32-bit version, or also called x86 version. It only has a 64-bit version and then an ARM or ARM64 version. So these ARM-based processors were mostly found in mobile devices and then embedded systems, but recently they've been starting to use them in server and desktop environments and some laptops too. So one of these PCs is a Copilot Plus PC, and like the Google search says here, it's a new category of Windows 11 devices designed to be AI powered, and it features a powerful neural processing unit, also called an NPU, that can perform more than 40 trillion operations per second. So these PCs are equipped with all-day battery life and have access to advanced AI models, enabling new AI-driven experiences. So to sum it all up, these ARM or ARM-based processors is much more efficient when it comes to performance and battery life, and it's also better for AI-driven tasks. Now, if you want to check what type of processor you have in your PC, you can just right-click on your start button. Then you can click on System, and in this new window, you'll find the system type, and it'll tell you what type of processor you have. So I've got an x64 based processor or a 64-bit processor, but if you have an ARM based processor, it'll clearly tell you that it's an ARM or ARM64 based processor. So depending on your processor type, that'll determine which ISO file you need to download. If you have an ARM-based processor, you'll need to download the ISO file for ARM-based PCs. And if you have a normal x64-based processor, then you'll need to download the disk image file for x64 devices. So once you've identified that, you can download the correct ISO file. In this video, I'm going to show you how to download the ARM-based ISO file, because I already have videos on this channel showing you how you can download the normal Windows 11 ISO file, and I'll link those down in the description below. But to download the Windows 11 ISO file for ARM-based PCs, you can just scroll down and then click on this Select Download drop-down menu here, then select Windows 11 Multi-Edition ISO for ARM64. And then you can click on Download Now. So next, you'll be able to select the product language, and you'll have a bunch of options here, but you will notice that English has two versions. It has English United States and then English International. Now, if you're doing a clean install of Windows, then it doesn't really matter that much what you choose here. Basically, if you're in the United States, you'll choose the United States, but if you're in another part of the world, you'll choose English International. But I will show you one thing that you can do to check what you currently have installed. And what you can do is you can right-click on your start button, then you can open either Windows Terminal, Windows PowerShell, or Command Prompt as admin, whichever option you have here. You can open that, and then in this new window, you can type the following command, as you can see on screen now. And I'll also include this in my written guide that I'll have linked in the description of this video. But if you run this command, you'll get a bunch of info with regards to your settings. And what you want to have a look at is the installed languages that you have here. So you can see for me, it's ENUS, which means it's English US. So this is only really important when you do an in-place upgrade and not a clean install of Windows. But regardless, you can do that. You can check what's installed on your current system, and then you can select the option that you currently have installed. So for me, it's going to be English United States. Then I'm going to click on Confirm. Now you can see that I've got an error saying we were unable to complete your request at this time. And this happens sometimes. You can try refreshing the page and then just go through the download process again. Select the language and then confirm. And there you can see it worked the second time around. So now I can download the Windows 11 ARM64 English ISO file. And if I click on the Download Now button, it'll start the download for the latest version of Windows 11 ARM64 ISO file. Now, once this ISO file has finished downloading, you can either use it to do an in-place upgrade on your computer, so you can upgrade to the latest version of Windows 11, or you can use it to do a clean install of Windows on your ARM64-based based device. And in that case, you'll need to write it to a USB flash drive so you can boot from that USB flash drive. And I have two videos on this channel showing you how you can do that, as well as other guides on how you can go through the Windows installation process. But I hope this video has been helpful and informative to you. If it was, please give it a like. And as always, I just want to give a shout out to my YouTube members. Thanks so much for your support. I really appreciate it. And I'll talk to all of you guys soon.